رأيت الذنوب تميت القلوب ويقطعها الظلم إدمانها وترك الذنوب حياة القلوب وخير لنفسك عصيانها رأيت الذنوب تميت القلوب ويتبعها الذل إدمانها وترك الذنوب حياة القلوب.
أعوذ بالله من الشيطان الرجيم. بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم. الحمد لله رب العالمين، قدم من شاء بفضله وأخر من شاء بعدله، لا يعترض عليه ذو عقل بعقله، ولا يسأله مخلوق عن علة فعله. هو الكريم الوهاب، منشئ السحاب ومسبب الأسباب، ومنزل الكتاب وخالق الناس من تراب. نحمده سبحانه ونستعين به ونستغفره، ونعوذ بالله تعالى من شرور أنفسنا ومن سيئات أعمالنا. من يهده الله فلا مضل له، ومن يضلل فلن تجد له وليا مرشدا. وأشهد أن لا إله إلا الله وحده لا شريك له، له الملك وله الحمد، يحيي ويميت، وهو على كل شيء قدير. وأشهد أن محمدا عبد الله ورسوله وصفيه من خلقه وخليله، أرسله الله رحمة للعالمين فشرح به الصدور وأنار به العقول وفتح به أعينا عميا وآذانا صما وقلوبا غلفا، جاهد في الله حق جهاده حتى أتاه اليقين، وتركنا على المحجة البيضاء ليلها كنهارها لا يزيغ عنها إلا هالك. فاللهم صل على هذا الرسول الكريم وزد وبارك عليه وعلى آله وأصحابه وأحبابه وأتباعه، وعلى كل من استنى بسنته واهتدى بهديه واقتفى أثره إلى يوم الدين. أما بعد، فإن أصدق الحديث كتاب الله عز وجل، وأحسن الهدي هدي سيدنا محمد صلى الله عليه وسلم، وشر الأمور محدثاتها، وكل محدثة بدعة، وكل بدعة ضلالة، ألا وكل ضلالة في النار. بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم. يا أيها الذين آمنوا اتقوا الله حق تقاته ولا تموتن إلا وأنتم مسلمون. الله سبحانه وتعالى says in this verse in Surah Al Imran, O you have attained to the call of faith, have taqwa from Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala as taqwa should be, and thy not accepting the state of Islam. ويقول جل وعلا في أواخر سورة الأحزاب: بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم. يا أيها الذين آمنوا اتقوا الله وقولوا قولا سديدا يصلح لكم أعمالكم ويغفر لكم ذنوبكم، ومن يطع الله ورسوله فقد فاز فوزا عظيما. Or you have attained to the call of faith, have taqwa from Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala and speak just. So may Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala fix your affairs and forgive your sins. And whoever obeys Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala and His Messenger sallallahu alayhi wa sallam will attain the ultimate success, the greatest success and happiness in this dunya and in the hereafter. أما بعد، إخواني الفضلاء وأخواتي الفضليات، طبتم جميعا وطاب ممشاكم وتبوأتم من الجنة منزلا، وأسأل الله العلي القدير الذي جمعنا في هذه الساعة المباركة على محبته وطاعته أن يجمعنا مع سيد النبيين في جنته ودار كرامته، إنه ولي ذلك ومولاه. أما بعد، just read this verse in the beginning of the khutbah, actually the two verses. يا أيها الذين آمنوا اتقوا الله حق تقاته. O you who believe, have taqwa from Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala as taqwa should be. Don't just have taqwa, as taqwa haqqa tuqatihi. As taqwa should be. Go rewind, go a little bit to the previous, this verse in Surah Al Imran. Go to the previous surah, in Surah Al Baqarah, about the verses like 182. In the ayat, the verses of Siyam in Surah Al-Baqarah, where Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala said, يا أيها الذين آمنوا كتب عليكم الصيام كما كتب على الذين من قبلكم لعلكم تتقون. Probably heard this verse in the first khutbah, may Allah A'lam, I don't know, but probably heard this verse in the beginning of Ramadan. We are coming to the month of fasting. Why are we fasting? يَا الَّذِينَ آمَنُوا اتَّقُوا اللَّهِ كُتِبَ عَلَيْكُمُ الصِّيَامُ كَمَا كُتِبَ عَلَى الَّذِينَ مِنْ قَبْلِكُمْ لَعَلَّكُمْ تَتَّقُونَ so that you may attain taqwa. And in this verse in Surah Ali Imran, have taqwa from Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala as taqwa should be. My dear brothers and sisters, the taqwa is the objective not only of the siyam, but all of the ibadah. Every ibadah has got that objective, which is to attain the real taqwa, the haqq taqwa, as taqwa should be. Read with me this verse, verse number 21 in Surah Al-Baqarah, as well. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, Ya ayyuha an-nasu abudu rabbakum. O people, worship Allah. U'budu rabbakum. Alladhi khalaqakum walladhina min qablikum la'allakum tattaqoon. So see here, u'budu rabbakum have the all the ibadah, and of course fasting is part of the is one big pillars of ibadah. One of the most important ibadah is fasting, the one that has got no rewards. Nama yawaffa as-sabira. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says, everything you do is for you and you can't accept illa siyam fa innahu li wa ana ajdi bih. So fasting, it is for me. I will not, that's a whole topic, a whole different topic, what is the tafsir of this hadith al-Qudsi, where Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, everything you do is for you, except fasting, it is for me. But we pray for Allah as well, we pay charity for Allah, we give zakah for, we do everything for Allah. Everything we do is for the sake of Allah, for Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. So, but why Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says, fasting, illa siyam, except fasting, it is for me, wa ana ajdi bih. So the malaika doesn't write rewards about fasting. They just write that this person has fasted, and leave the reward to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Why? Because fasting is like part of the sabr. Allah says in the Quran, إِنَّمَا يُوَفَّ الصَّابِرُونَ أَجْرَهُمْ بِغَيْرِ حِسَابٍ. These people of sabr, people of perseverance, they have been given the reward beyond count, بِغَيْرِ حِسَابٍ, without حِسَابٍ. وَقِيلَ فِي الْحَدِيثِ وَالصَّوْمُ نِصْفُ الصَّبْرِ. In another hadith, it says that fasting is half of the sabr. And half of infinity is infinity as well, as you know. But just putting the whole, these all things in perspective. Why I'm fasting? To attain that taqwa. Taqwa is the purpose of all the ibadat. In the beginning of the month, in perhaps also heard in a khutbah in Sha'ban here, where the famous hadith that Rasulullah sallallahu alaihi wasallam says, Allah, when Sha'ban used to come, Allahumma barik lana fi Sha'ban wa balighna Ramadan. Oh Allah, give us barakah in this month of Sha'ban and give us another barakah to attain Ramadan, to witness Ramadan. How many brothers and sisters did not reach Ramadan? How many? How many they couldn't make it? They passed away just before Ramadan. May Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala have mercy in their soul and have rahmah on them and give them the rewards of Ramadan also, inshaAllah. But because the Ramadan, that's a golden opportunity. And the real loser, who will have the opportunity and he will not seize it. As inshaAllah, Allah will give you this beautiful, no equivalent opportunity, and you just waste it. I hate soccer, yeah, but imagine that someone is playing soccer and just him and the khalas, yeah, his team did very hard work to give him the ball and he just kicked it out. And it's not even the goalkeeper who's there. I just kicked it out. Sorry for the analogy, I hate soccer myself. But just for the youngsters here who may relate, opportunity. قال ابن عطال السكندري في الحكم. Listen to these words of wisdom of Imam Ahmad. Imam Ahmad ibn عطال السكندري. قال من علامات موت القلب عدم الندم على ما فات من الموافقات مع وجود الزلات. من علامات موت القلب عدم الندم على ما فات من الموافقات مع وجود الزلات. From the signs of dead heart that missing out opportunities and without regret. That someone will miss this opportunity, it's okay. Ramadan came, Ramadan passed, Laylatul Qadr came, the last 10 days of Ramadan came, and like first day of Ramadan, inshallah, I will work in the last, yani by the middle of Ramadan, just warm up, inshallah, by mid Ramadan, I will be okay. And then mid Ramadan comes, last 10 days, I'm going to atikaf, I'm doing this last 10 days. Last 10 days, Laylatul Qadr in the witri night, in the odd numbered night. So I just focus on those 5 nights in the last 10 days. And then I was like, likely it is the night of 27. So just come up and then what happened? The typical pattern. Inshallah, next Ramadan I will be as if he knows that he will live until next Ramadan. It is opportunities. See the dua, the ni'mah of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, this ni'mah of Ramadan. You also know the hadith that Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam said, لَوْ عَلِمَ النَّاسْ مَا رَمَضَانَ لَتَمَنَّوْا أَن تَكُونَ السَّنَةُ كُلُّهَا رَمَضَانَ. If people would know what Ramadan really is, they would wish that the whole year is Ramadan. At times where you start having your self-conscious, you start abstaining from, and look at this inside, what do we abstain from in Ramadan? Different from other days. Things that are halal, it's not haram. What is the original hukm of having lunch? Eating and having like chicken, biryani, our water in the at lunch time outside Ramadan. Mubah, permissible. It's food you're eating and drinking. What is the hukm of having the marital relationship with your wife? Halal outside the weeks, the holidays, their week, everyone. It's halal. But in the day there is Ramadan, the halal becomes haram. So we abstain from halal. Imagine what do we need to do now for the haram. If I have to abstain from the halal, كيف نصوم عن الحلال ونفطر على حرام. How come we abstain from halal things during daytime of Ramadan, but then I break my fast on haram? How can outside in the nights of Ramadan do anything haram? Backbiting, cheating, gossip. People gather for iftar and they start talking about other people, backbiting other people. Did you really understand what Ramadan is? You have been the whole day time abstaining from halal, and then when you come and break your fast, I will not talk about those who backbite and cheat and lie in the daytime of Ramadan. They are abstaining from halal and they are doing haram on the daytime of Ramadan. But coming at iftar as if, right? How come, my dear brothers and sisters? This is, we must understand what is the ibadah, what is the purpose of the ibadah. Why do we worship Allah? To attain taqwa. What is taqwa? In a nutshell, this is another khutbah. What is taqwa? Doing what Allah loves and abstaining from what Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala doesn't love. In a nutshell. In another word, some other people define, some other ulama define the taqwa is that the purpose of the ibadah with this taqwa is actually two things. Two things that you need to achieve with every single ibadah. And listen to this. If before the ibadah I am the same like after the ibadah, I'll just try to be lenient as much as I can. Check yourself. Have a big question. Sit with you. I advise, go home or sit with yourself. What am I doing? If you are the same person after every ibadah, like the same person before that ibadah, if that ibadah didn't change you, didn't make you a better person, and when I say every ibadah, it's every salah. You pray 5 times a day. You must be in continuous improvement. After that salah, I'm supposed to be a better person than who I was 15 minutes ago. Inshallah, now imagine we're going to pray Jum'ah now and Asr, and pray with this intention. Allah, inshallah, I will be better than, after I finish this salah, I will be a better person. My spiritual, my purity of my heart, my akhlaq, my manners, my love to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, my yaqeen in Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, my tawakkul in Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, it will be better. And then after, and the quality of your ibadah will define that. How much better you are depends on the quality of that ibadah, the ikhlas and the sincerity. So the purpose of the ibadah is just two things, the two wings of the bird that doesn't fly without each, without both of them. جناحي الطائر الذي لا يطير إلا بهما ولا ينهض إلا بهما. The two wings of the bird for every ibadah. Number one, the first objective of the ibadah, تحقيق العبودية لله سبحانه وتعالى. To affirm your relationship with Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala as one of His slaves, as a servant to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, the slave of Allah, the abd min ibadillah. What is your relationship to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala? Like Allah wants and I want. Allah says so but I think otherwise. Allah and His Messenger sallallahu alayhi wa sallam said this but I want this. Is this the kind of relation? Is this the kind of a slave and his master? Huh? Who are we? Are we gods with Allah? Allah says in Surah Ahzab, مَا كَانَ لِمُؤْمِنٍ وَلَا مُؤْمِنَةٍ إِذَا قَضَى اللَّهُ وَرَسُولُهُ أَمْرًا أَن يَكُونَ لَهُمُ الْخِيَرَةُ مِنْ أَمْرِهِمْ. Surah Al-Ahzab, it is not up to a believer, male or female. مُؤْمِنٍ وَلَا مُؤْمِنَةٍ إِذَا قَضَى اللَّهُ وَرَسُولُهُ أَمْرًا. When Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala and His Messenger decree something, that you have a choice. If you think after Allah decrees something, I have a choice, then all what I'm saying, look, I'm not a slave of you, Allah. I have my own mind, I have my own rules, I have my own ijtihad, I have my own, all this. This is not the relationship. Astaghfirullah. And Allah says in Surah An-Nisa as well, فَلَا وَرَبِّكَ لَا يُؤْمِنُونَ. Allah says, indeed, وَرَبِّكَ by Allah, they do not believe. They do not really believe. It is not a belief. لَا يُؤْمِنُونَ. They don't have iman. فَلَا وَرَبِّكَ لَا يُؤْمِنُونَ حَتَّى يُحَكِّمُوكَ فِيمَا شَجَرَ بَيْنَهُمْ ثُمَّ لَا يَجِدُوا فِي أَنفُسِهِمْ حَرَجًا مِمَّا قَضَيْتْ وَيُسَلِّمُوا تَسْلِيمًا. Three conditions of iman. لَا يُؤْمِنُونَ until يُحَكِّمُوكَ فِيمَا شَجَرَ بَيْنَهُمْ, until they take you, Allah, as Allah and His Messenger, as the ultimate reference. How do I make my decision, resolve disputes and conflicts and disagreements and choose paths, invest, how do I invest, how I make business, how I make every aspect in your life, to take Allah and His Messenger as the hakam, as the reference. Does it please them or not? Is it allowed or not? That's it. No. Still other two. حتى يعفوا. ثم لا يجدوا في أنفسهم حرجا مما قضيت. And on top of that, you don't find in your heart, in your chest, in your nafs, any discontent with what Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala wants. Because some people will comply. I really don't like this. You must know that whatever Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala has decreed for you, it is actually your absolute success and happiness. Even if it is not the thing that you particularly like. If it is against your hawa, if it is against your desires, but trust me, it is in your favor. It is your own success. It is your own happiness. يقول ابن عطاء السكندري كذلك, أوجب عليك العبادة وفي الحقيقة إنما أوجب عليك مطلق السعادة. Allah has made the ibadah fard on you, yes, but in reality what He has made fard on you, your own absolute success and happiness. Allah doesn't need the ibadah, the malaika, no one needs your ibadah. Who benefits from this ibadah, from this worship, from this salah, from this fasting, from this siyam? Who benefits? You are the only beneficiary of your own ibadah. Allah doesn't benefit from your ibadah. Allah doesn't need it. هل أتى على الإنسان حين من الدهر لم يكن شيئا مذكورا إنا خلقنا الإنسان من نطفة أمشاج نبتليه فجعلناه سميعا بصيرا و You are in the last 10 days of Ramadan. Ramadan khalas, before you think, before you know, it will be gone. It is finished. No one can bring the clock back. No one can bring every day that passes back. No one can, the opportunities that you miss, the only thing that you can do about it is regret. Deep sorrow and regret about the missed opportunity. That's the only thing you can do. But why putting ourselves in this situation in the first place? The opportunity is still few days ahead of us in Ramadan. Seize this opportunity. Don't put yourself in a situation where the only thing I can do is sorrow and regret. Do something about it. And then the other wing of the bird. So what you need to do now, حق تحقيق العبودية لله, the first objective of the ibadah. I don't want to lose you. So I was saying about the two wings of the bird, the two objectives of any ibadah. Number one is تحقيق العبودية لله. Affirming your relationship with Allah as a slave. Allah says, do this. In this particular month from Fajr to Maghrib, you don't have the halal, the food, drink. You go to Hajj, do 7 tawaf around the Kaaba, take off your clothes and wear the ihram. Go and between two mountains, between two big rocks, just do the sa'i. And go to another rock and throw 7 pebbles here, 7 pebbles, 7 pebbles. Why am I doing this? Why am I going between two rocks and throwing other 7 rocks here 3 times and then go around another building, another rock? Why? تحقيق العبودية لله. Allah says, and we do. حتى يحكموك فيما شجر بينهم. For those of you who will be going to Hajj, those of you who are fasting, alhamdulillah, all of you are fasting. Every salah, every Hajj, every siyam, I am Allah, I'm affirming, I'm just doing what you asked, what you told me to do. I am your slave, Allah. After that, enjoy, wallahi, enjoy the blessings. When you have this relationship, who's the beneficiary? You. Wallahi, you will be a powerful person. You will be a wise person. Allah will give you wisdom. Well, you will be rich. I'll tell you a secret in the second khutbah, inshallah, about it. But what happens when you become a slave of Allah? Every human, any other person other than Allah, you become a slave. If you become a slave to a dollar, you become a slave to a position, you become a slave to another person, you become a slave to your desires, you will be humiliated. Al-Malik, Malik Yawm al-Din, he himself subhanahu wa ta'ala, when you become a slave to him, you become person of admiration. Allah will give you izzah. You will be an admired person, respected person, high person. Man, read with me in Surah Fatir. Man kana yuridu al-izzah. Whoever wants izzah, victory and success and glory and admiration, what do you need to do? Man kana yuridu al-izzah falillahi al-izzatu jami'a ilayhi yas'adu al-kalimu al-tayyibu wal-amalu al-salihu yarfa'u. Whoever wants the izzah to be a aziz, indeed the whole izzah belongs to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. وَلِلَّهِ الْعِزَّةُ وَلِرَسُولِهِ وَلِلْمُؤْمِنِينَ. And to Allah belongs the absolute izzah and to His Prophet and all the believers. You will get the izzah. And I will speak about that in the second khutbah. أَقُولُ قَوْلِ هَذَا وَأَسْتَغْفِرُ اللَّهَ لِي وَلَكُمْ. الحمد لله كما هدانا أن نحمد والصلاة والسلام على أشرف الخلق سيدنا محمد وعلى آله وصحبه وسلم. Before I go to that part, I will just say the other wing of the ibadah. After affirming that relationship with Allah سبحانه وتعالى as the عبد of Allah, number two, the benefit of the ibadah, maqsad of the ibadah is to reap the fruits of this ibadah. So for you to start being a better person, have the fruits of this ibadah, the qualities of this ibadah reflect back on you. Cleans your heart, clears your brain, makes you a sharper person, a well-mannered person. تَخَلَّقُ بِأَخْلَاقِ اللَّهِ. Rasulullah said, تَخَلَّقُ بِأَخْلَاقِ اللَّهِ. have the manners of Allah. I'm a abd. Allah is kareem, you should be generous. Allah is rahim, you should be have mercy. Allah is jawad, you should be extra generous. Allah takhallaqu bi akhlaqillah. And here comes to the final point. When I do this, when I worship Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala with this understanding, understanding the real essence of the ibadah, what happens? صرها الإمام بن عطاء السكندري كذلك في الحكم فقال إذا تحققت بعبوديتك غطى وصفك بوصفه ونعتك بنعته فأوصلك بما كان منه إليك لا بما كان منك إليه. إذا تحققت بوصفك, when you clear that relationship between you and Allah, what will happen to you? قال غطى وصفك بوصفه ونعتك بنعته. He will cover your own weak qualities with his own powerful qualities. So he will take you to reach the izzah to him, not because of your own doing, but because of his what he has blessed you with. So what does it mean? Cover your weak attributes and your weak qualities with his own qualities, powerful qualities. The faqr. Allah says in Surah Al-Fatiha, يَا أَيُّهَا النَّاسُ أَنْتُمُ الْفُقَرَاءُ إِلَى اللَّهِ وَاللَّهُ هُوَ الْغَنِيُّ الْحَمِيدُ إِيَّ شَأْ يُذْهِبُكُمْ وَيَأْتِ بِخَلْقٍ جَدِيدٍ. Says, all of us are poor, all of us are needy. Allah, you are in need for Allah to bless you with your blinking, with your heartbeats, with your kidneys that purifies your blood, with the liver, with... Who controls all this? Don't tell me you are so smart that you control all these systems inside you. وَفِي أَنفُسِكُمْ أَفَلَا تُبُسِرُونَ. Every one of us is a faqir to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. If you displease him, you're risking. What if he stops one of these systems inside you? What if you need an artificial kidney to purify your blood 3 times a week? Thank Allah, have shukru of Allah. How can you? He controls everything. But see, we are faqir. That's we antum al-fuqara ila Allah. And Allah huwa al-ghani, and Allah is the rich. What those who are ibad to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, guess what? Their neediness, the state of being needy and faqir, Allah will make them look like rich. Allah will make them rich. Allah will make them self-sufficient. You see some people saying, mashallah, this brother is wealthy. He may not have so much money. There are people who have like eight figures in their bank account. 7, 8 figures in their bank account. Their income is like $50 million a year. I know them. But guess what? They are living miserable life. They are one of the poorest people on earth. They are in need. They feel that they are missing a lot of things. They are mahroom. While others who may have only normal $2,000 a month or $500 a week, sorry, or $700, but he's so rich, he doesn't need anything. Has everything in life. When I used to have my sheikh in Azhar in Egypt, a normal sheikh, what is his salary? £200 a month, that's $50 a month at that time. Every 30 of us students will go to his house, he will feed all of us the best food. Barbecue, I'm saying barbecue, baba ghanouj, gulab jam, la no gulab jam in Egypt. Just the baklawa and beautiful food, and he will feed every year. How come? He doesn't need. He's ghani, he's rich. Right? You are a da'if, you and I are a da'if, we are weak. Wallahu qawi. You will be strong. Some people just become so powerful. You will become powerful, the right power, not the wrong power. Not the destructive power that will destruct you, like Qarun, that Allah did to Qarun and Fir'aun. Allah drowned them, Allah destroyed them. They had fake power. Those people, powerful people, the most powerful man on planet, the president of blah blah blah, this fake power. You will have the real, genuine power. Right? Al-Faqr wal-Izzah. Everyone is the dhalil to Allah. You will get the Izzah. You will become Qawi. You will become rich. You will become Aziz. All this happens when you become a true slave of Allah. This is the last 10 days. Do. Spend from what you love. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala said, لَن تَنَالُوا الْبِرَّ حَتَّى تُنْفِقُوا مِمَّا تُحِبُّونَ. If you love sleeping, wake up. Wake up early. Because this is what I love to be lazy. I love to sleep all night. Now spend from that what you love. Sacrifice part of your sleep to stand up and pray. If you are a busy person, I'm busy, I take $1 million. But just don't ask me for 1 minute. I'm a busy person. 1 minute does nothing to me. لَن تَنَالُوا الْبِرَّ حَتَّى تُنْفِقُوا مِمَّا تُحِبُّونِ. You will not achieve birr unless you spend from what you love. Give time. Sit and read the... If you are a busy person, sit and read Quran. If you love money, and that's all of us, give charity. Especially now, give charity. Do you believe the promise of Allah or not? Allah says, الشَّيْطَانُ يَعِدُكُمُ الْفَقْرِ وَيَأْمُرُكُمْ بِالْفَحْشَاءِ Surah Al-Baqarah. وَاللَّهُ يَعِدُكُمْ مَغْفِرَةً مِّنْهُ وَفَضْلًا. Which promise? إِنَّمَا الْوَعْدُ وَعَدَانِ. Promises are just only two promises. The shaitan promises you poverty. If you spend, you get poorer. Brother, don't give this $1,000, $500. It's too much. Give only $5. Huh? Why? Because you fear poverty. Then you believe the promise of the shaitan. يَعَدُكُمُ الْفَقْرِ. He promises you poverty if you give for the sake of Allah. But Allah promises مَغْفِرَةً مِّنْهُ وَفَضْلًا, that when you give for His sake, He will forgive you and He will give you back in multifolds. وَمَا أَنْفَقْتُمْ مِّنْ شَيْءٍ فَهُوَ يُخْلِفُ وَمَا نَقَسَ مَالٌ مِّنْ صَدَقٍ. And so on. You all know this ahadith. So now have this focus. Inshallah, make it a change that after Ramadan I will be a different person. So this ibadah, I have a sign that this ibadah is accepted. That this month is accepted from me, because unfortunately many people, the month, it is like after the month, it's like wrapped up like a piece of paper and thrown back in the faces of people who did fast. Like every salah, some salah goes to the gates of heaven and they're thrown back in the faces of the people who pray because of low quality. Adam ikhlas, there is no ikhlas, there is no this and that. And no one can judge what, I cannot judge this, no one can judge, only Allah judges. So please go and judge the people. Huh? Only Allah knows. So don't be a judge on anyone. But all what you can do is just put your best effort, your ikhlas, your focus, your sincerity, your sacrifice from your time, from your sleep, from your money to achieve that. And then you get the two farhatan, the two happiness. After the Ramadan, the farha when you meet Allah, and before that, the farha when you break your fast. Make it a change, you'll become a better person after that, inshallah. They ask me to do an announcement. There is a collection today at the masjid that goes all over the world. The most trusted charity organization in Australia, if not the whole world, it's Muslim Aid Australia. So please give just, I was just asked to give this announcement. I'll finish the khutbah. Subhanallah, bihamdika, astaghfiruka, wa natubu ilaykum, ashhadu an la ilaha illa ant. Allahumma salli wa sallim wa barik ala sayyidina Muhammad wa alihi wa sahbihi wa sallim. Allahumma la taj'alana fi hadha al-yawm al-'azim dhanban illa ghafartahu, wa la mayyitan illa rahimtah, wa la sadran dayyqan illa sharahtah, wa la hajata min hawa'ij ad-dunya laka fiha ridha wa la fiha salaha illa yassartaha wa qadaytaha ya rabbal alamin. Allahumma wahhib bayna sufufil muslimin wa alif bayna qulubil mu'minin bi rahmatika ya arhamar rahimin. Allahumma kull man arada bina bil islam wal muslimin su'an faj'al kaydahu fi nahrihi ya rabbal العالمين. وكل من أراد بنا بالإسلام والمسلمين خيرا فوفق لكل خير. وصلى الله على سيدنا محمد وعلى آله وصحبه وسلم.
وخير لنفسك عصيانها. رأيت الذنوب تميت القلوب ويتبعها الذل إنها.